The XPRIZE project has been a really fantastic opportunity for me to get research experience and to be part of something that I could potentially spin off into a further master's or PhD project.
The technology that we developed is, formally it's known as oxidative hydrothermal dissolution, but frankly, even in geek speak, that's just too much of a mouthful, so everybody abbreviates it to OHD. Fundamentally, what OHD is, it's a very simple technological process that breaks down complicated organic materials into very simple water-soluble organic materials. So we can take things like coal or biomass or plastic or other kinds of materials, big things, usually solid things, some liquids, and we can process those through our technology and break them down into something that's functionally equivalent to a really intense tea. So it's an aqueous liquid with a lot of organic material dissolved in it. What we can do is take the carbon that plants have already captured from the atmosphere, break that down into a water-soluble product, and then put that water with the carbon that it contains underground. That ultimately is carbon capture. One of the things we were really concerned about is we don't want to make anything toxic and, you know, risk doing something that's going to have detrimental effects in the long term. We want to be careful. Our whole goal from the beginning was to be benign as far as the environment is concerned. So we needed a microbiologist. We needed to know what would happen to this material if we put it down into the earth.
My name is Scott Hamilton Bream, an associate professor of microbiology at Southern Illinois University, Carbondale. My focus is with extreme organisms or extremophiles, organisms that live in extreme environments. And deep underground, while people don't really think about it, there is a huge consortium of microbes down there, and we hardly know anything about them. So will this liquid carbon interact with, will it kill them? Will they eat it? We don't actually know that part. And so luckily my lab is built and has microbes from deep underground. And we can directly test indigenous subsurface microbes with the liquid carbon. And then we can see what happens. Research at any university depends upon the students. Tia Zimmerman and Bethany Egge are my key students who are working on any type of environmental developments with the liquefied carbon.
I first became interested in carbon sequestration really as soon as I discovered that that was something that we could do. I think that climate change is one of the most defining topics of our generation. And if there's something that I can do to make a difference, then I want to do that. And working in Dr. Scott's lab, I feel like I can help move towards a solution that really could be a sustainable way to store carbon for generations to come.
I work in Dr. Scott Hamilton Bream's lab as a researcher on the Carbon Down Under project. I do experimental design in our lab. So we have our subsurface microorganisms that we've acquired, and we're trying to grow them in our lab.
Our bioreactors mimic the conditions of the deep subsurface, which includes conditions such as the acidity, the saline content, and the temperature, as well as the added benefit of our bioreactors have no oxygen, which is also true deep underground.
Experiments show that the microbes actually, they tolerate it and they reorganize themselves to consume it. That's really good news. That means the environment is not opposed to receiving that liquid carbon. This is a planetary scale problem, and the solutions have to be planetary in their magnitude. And OHD can scale up and it can meet the challenge.
Right now, we have the chance to make a difference, so that difference needs to be made right now.
To learn more about XPRIZE Carbon Removal, head to xprize.org/carbonremoval.